Blackstone presents Rants from the Hill on Packrats, Bobcats, Wildfires, Curmudgeons, a Drunken Mary K-Lady, and other encounters with the wild in the high desert by Michael P. Branch. This book is read by David Marantz. Benedictio. May your trails be crooked, winding, lonesome, dangerous, leading to the most amazing view. May your mountains rise into and above the clouds. May your rivers flow without end, meandering through pastoral valleys tinkling with bells, past temples and castles and poets' towers, into a dark primeval forest where tigers belch and monkeys howl. Through miasmal and mysterious swamps, and down into a desert of red rock, blue mesas, domes and pinnacles and grottos of endless stone, and down again into a deep, vast, ancient unknown chasm where bars of sunlight blaze on profiled cliffs, where deer walk across the white sand beaches, where storms come and go as lightning clangs upon the high crags, where something strange and more beautiful and more full of wonder than your deepest dreams waits for you beyond that next turning of the canyon walls. Edward Abbey, preface to the 1988 reprint of Desert Solitaire, 1968. The View from Ranting Hill. I was not always devoted to the pastoral fantasy of living in the remote high desert of the American West. Earlier in life, I worked my way through the serial pastoral fantasies of withdrawing from the din and superficiality of over-civilization to a rustic life in the Blue Ridge Mountains, by the Atlantic seashore, and in a Florida swamp. But I like to think that I have become more focused over time as I succumbed and committed to the driest and most impossible of pastoral fantasies more than 20 years ago. I am now a confirmed desert rat. It might be said that all things pastoral are a form of fantasy, in the sense that our escapist dreams are our least achievable and most necessary. But there was something especially irrational about my passionate desire to retreat to a landscape as extreme and inhospitable as the one that became my home. The Great Basin is the largest of American deserts, a 190,000 square mile immensity of alien territory that rolls out from the Rockies west to the Sierra Nevada, bordered on the north by the Columbia Plateau, and down south by those better-known deserts, the Mojave and Sonoran. From this inconceivably vast desert basin, no drop of water ever reaches the sea. Out here in northern Nevada, on the far western edge of the Great Basin, we live in the rain shadow of the Sierra, which limits our annual precipitation to about 7 inches. Because the elevation here is almost 6,000 feet, it is cold here as well as hot, subject to blizzard as well as wildfire, and characterized by extremes of weather and temperature unmatched by any other U.S. state. While environmental writers often deploy the metaphor of falling in love to evoke a magical moment of intimacy with a natural landscape, the Great Basin Desert is so titanic, inhospitable, and unwelcoming that the urge to dwell here is not easily understood, even by those of us who have chosen to act on it. Given that pastoral fantasies remain perpetually vulnerable to threats as simple as bad weather or the need for a day job, my attempt at bucolic retreat in this land of wildfire, hypothermia, desiccation, and rattlers might seem ill-advised, but the sheer vastness and starkness of this place attracted me and then worked on me slowly over time, like wind on rock, until I had no ambition greater than to make a life in these high, dry wilds. Finding the way out here was a long, challenging process. Initially, my wife Erin and I moved to a semi-rural area about 15 miles northwest of Reno, Nevada. There, we hiked, gardened, and played music, but also worked, saved, and planned, always eyeing a move even farther into the hinterlands. After several years, we had saved enough to begin our search for a piece of raw land in a spectacular but isolated area of desert hills and canyons adjacent to public lands and at the foot of a stunning split-summited 8,000-foot mountain. Because it was so distant, high elevation, fire-prone, and so frequently rendered inaccessible by snow, mud, and terrible roads, land in this area.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.